Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be reviewing, demoing, and doing a wear test on Rihanna's Fenty Beauty Foundation. And the proper name for this is Pro Filter Soft Matte Longwear Foundation, but I'm just gonna call it the Fenty Beauty Foundation. I am so excited to be doing this video because I have been testing this foundation out for the past couple months to the point that I am like right here with this foundation. So I'm halfway through and I literally had to be like, I have to film this video now because otherwise I'm gonna run out of this foundation before I even get a chance to review it. So here we are. I hope you guys are as excited as I am. I'm not sure if that's possible, but I hope you are. And before we jump into the application process, let me just give you a few quick information bits about this foundation so you know the price point and all that stuff. Since we're talking about price, it is $34 for 1.08 ounces. The 1.08 ounces, that's pretty standard for size for like a regular size foundation, and the price is $34, which is actually on the lower price side of things for like higher end Sephora foundation. I feel like they're usually in the 40 to 50 range. This is like 30, mid 30, so that's great. It's not the cheapest foundation out there, but it's definitely not the most expensive. It comes in 40 shades, okay? That's amazing. I love that Rihanna went out and said, this is how you come out with a foundation range. We're talking light shades, we're talking dark shades, we're talking all sorts of different undertones. And my shade is 190, and everything is gonna be linked down below, not only the foundation, but also the rest of my makeup, because I know you guys are always asking for that. So you ask, I deliver. For me, I have a problem finding the right undertone. I have like a lot of yellow in my skin, and a lot of foundations come with like pink red undertone and they look just too pink and red for me. So I can say that for me, I was able to find the right color, which is great. And I think that a lot of you, in fact, I think all of you will be able to find something that you can live with and be happy with. 40 shades, that's amazing. So kudos to Fenty Beauty and kudos to Rihanna for doing that for everybody. As far as the claims, this is soft matte longwear foundation with buildable medium to full coverage. And before jumping ahead too much, I will tell you that I think the description here is pretty accurate. It is a soft matte. It's supposed to be really good for those of us who have oily or combinational skin because it is going to keep your skin nice and matte. It is a medium to full coverage and it is buildable. It's not like a 100% full coverage, but it does give you a good amount of coverage. And it's also not too thick. So if you don't like those types of like thick but high coverage foundations, it's not like that. It is a higher coverage foundation, but it's not like goopy or thick. I don't know why I'm jumping into like the next part of the video, but I guess I want to give you a heads up as far as like what it's all about before you get too far in the video in case that's not what you're looking for. But all right, so I guess with that being said, let's jump into the next part of the video where I show you how this foundation goes on and all of that good stuff, and let's jump in. All right, so the foundation does have a pump, so I'm gonna take my pump foundation and put some on my beauty blender. It's a fairly runny consistency, nothing like too runny, nothing too thick, and I guess I'm just gonna dive right into it. It looks quite shiny when you apply, but I know it's a matte foundation, so I'm curious to see how fast it's going to mattify. It's got a really nice smell to it. Kind of smells like a guy. I think I've said that before in videos, but to me this smells like a really nice guy. All right, this is going to be an interesting side because I do have a lot of acne here, and we'll see how much it covers up. Covered up pretty good, huh? Look at that. All right, I'm down for this. That's exciting. Take me with you, full coverage foundation that's also thin. Oh, I might be taking foundation off. I don't know. I'm gonna stop. Take it away from me. All right, you guys. So I'm ready to give you my first quick impressions right after I applied it. First of all, this is a matte foundation, as you probably know that already. When you first apply it, it does feel kind of like shiny, but then it dries fairly quickly. Not so quickly that you can't blend it out. It's not like one of those foundations, but I feel like it does dry pretty quickly and it gives you a beautiful, almost like you've powdered your face, but you haven't powdered your face feel. Like it just feels like velvety matte. It doesn't feel drying. My skin doesn't feel like it lost all its moisture, but it does feel matte, which I like. So it's like my favorite finish ever for foundations. Matte, but like not too matte. It has a good amount of coverage. I would say it's like medium to high, but not like 100%, because I can still see a little bit of acne poking through. but it covered up a good amount, especially for how thin it is. So starting with the forehead, as you can see, the foundation is not really sitting on the skin. I think it's looking pretty natural. Moving down to the middle of my face, we do have some pores. This is like my pore zone area. I don't think this foundation did much for pores. Like, it didn't accentuate them, but it also did not cover them up either. I was hoping maybe it would, but it didn't. But it also didn't claim that. So I guess we're moving on now. Going down to my mouth area, and this is my crease prone area and also my dry area. I do have oily skin typically and still, but I have some dryness going on right now because it's winter time, it's cold, my skin decided to be all dry for whatever reason. So we'll see how this foundation is doing with creasing right here with my smile lines, and also how it's gonna be doing with dry patches. This does feel kind of like really powdery and nice. Like, honestly, I could probably get away without applying powder. I'm going to, but if you want a foundation that you don't actually need to powder after, this would be the foundation for that. Okay, guys, so I'm gonna be back with an update in a couple hours with my final finished makeup look. Hi, guys, I am back with the rest of my makeup all nice and done, and it has been 2 hours since I first applied this foundation on my face, so I did take some time doing my makeup today, but I guess this is gonna be our first update for the video, and I am happy to say that I'm really, really into this foundation and I love the way it's looking so far. So I love the finish of it. It's a nice matte finish but not dehydrating. I like how it's not accentuating any pores or any wrinkles. It's not settling in my smile lines yet. I'm gonna see how it's doing at the end of the day, but so far so good. I like how it's looking pretty natural, but yet is giving me the coverage. I did not find that my acne has shown up or anything like that. I did not have to go back and cover the acne, which is great. Again, it's not like a full coverage foundation, but it is one that I find to be pretty high coverage. So I know I say I have acne, and I did get a couple comments from you guys saying like, oh my god, you don't have acne, stop saying that, it's making me feel bad. And I'm really sorry if that's how it's coming off. I don't mean it like that at all, and I actually don't like when people do that. I don't mean it to be like that. I'm just, I guess, you know, when I look in the mirror, I see certain imperfections in myself that maybe you guys don't see. That shows how we can be very self-critical, and I think the lesson here should be that we should not be self-critical. Okay, so I guess what I'm trying to say is my acne did get covered up by this foundation. If you have either the same amount of acne or maybe even more, I do think that you should find the coverage pretty nice. If you want like a super, super high coverage foundation, this is not it. But if you want something that's medium to high coverage and you're okay with having a little bit of something showing through, if it is like really red or really dark, then I think this should be perfectly fine. I'm loving this foundation so far. I think it's amazing. I think Rihanna did a great job with this foundation. I don't know how involved she is in this whole process of creating a beauty brand, but I sure hope she is, because kudos to her then. All right, you guys, so I'm going to be doing another update very soon and I'll see you then, but so far I'm so excited about this, and it's definitely gonna be one of my go-to foundations so far. Hi guys, I am back with my final update for this video. It has been about 9 hours since I first applied the foundation, and before I tell you what I think about it, let me just zoom in to show you how it's doing. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, let's start with the forehead, and then we're just gonna make our way down the list. Smile lines. I think overall the foundation has lasted really well, and my face is not a grease ball, which is quite unusual for my skin type, which is very oily. I give this foundation 2 thumbs up. I think it's great. I think it's long lasting, it's pretty high coverage, it's a nice velvety matte finish, which I'm loving. Overall, I think this is great, and for the price point of $34, I think it's so worth a try, especially if you have oily or combinational skin. But if you do suffer with dry skin, or if you do have flaky skin, this foundation may or may not be amazing for you, because I think this foundation is designed for people who do have oily to combinational skin. Although I think everybody can wear it, I think that if you do have, again, either oily or combinational skin, then I think it's best for you. Okay, so I think that's it for the video. I hope you guys have found this helpful. If you did find this helpful, make sure to give this video a thumbs up. Before you go, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more future videos. And with that being said, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.